is it? A total solar eclipse, correct?
Correct. Pretty rare thing. We don't see these things too often across the globe. We definitely don't see them in North America very often. And we definitely don't see them span the entire continent of North America.
So this is going to be, when you hear people say, most studied, most observed, it's accurate because it's
absolutely
right across the state,
yeah,
across the country.
It's going to start right around Portland, Oregon, just south of there. Make a nice big wide swath across the mountains and the plains and the prairies, and then exit out just north of Charleston, South Carolina.
And the great thing for North Carolina is at least part of the state will see totality, but all of the state will see something.
That's true. Mandiota Murphy. Murphy's a little better place to see it this time because they will actually see totality. But throughout the state of North Carolina, we're going to be able to see something and near totality through most of the state.
Okay, and when you say totality, right behind us, that picture, that's totality.
That's totality. That's the diamond ring phase. That's one that we really look forward to when just that last little glimmer of the sun is showing through there. And what we're actually physically seeing is the sun showing through a crater, a lunar crater. We think of the moon as being this perfect sphere, but it's not. It's got all pockmarks and craters like that. So it really brings to right to home some of these kind of things. But yes, totality is when the moon passes immediately in front of the sun and covers it up completely.
And I guess we should go back to the basics here. So a solar eclipse is when the moon comes between the Earth and the sun, correct?
Correct.
So if this is totality, then this is what the next picture here is what the Earth is going to be seeing. This is the shadow of the moon across the Earth, then, correct?
That's correct, and that's important here because this is physically what's happening. So when we talk about parts of North Carolina are going to be able to see totality, 100% of the sun covered up, this is why. It's actually a shadow being cast on westernmost North Carolina. That being said, though, the rest of those areas there, we're still going to be able to see a really good show. We're going to be able to see in the lower 90% of the sun being covered.
And if I've heard stories where if you are really in that shadow, it's nighttime. The wild animals start acting like it's nighttime. It's dark.
It is dark. The animals react to this. They think night's coming on, but we will feel the temperature in the air actually go down a little bit because of the sun being covered up for that period of time.
Now, why is this such a big deal? Other than it's beautiful. It's just really cool to use unscientific language. Why is this a big deal? It gives us a chance to study the sun, correct?
Well, it's a rare thing. You know, there's always that. But scientifically, it's a rare opportunity to study that outer atmosphere of the sun that we can't see because of the glare. We've got spacecraft up there that study these sorts of things. But down here on Earth, this is the only time we can see that outer atmosphere. It's a chance to study that with telescopes. But we can also do some things like validate Einstein's theories. Theory of general relativity is... we can validate that during a total eclipse.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk about looking at it and observing this. Again, you don't want to look at the sun. You always hear that. But Right. Even in that shadow, in that path of totality, it's still don't want to look at the sun. It's still bright.
Yeah, you need to be very, very careful. If you're in that path of totality, you can remove your glasses for that brief moment, those couple of minutes when it's completely covered. But most of North Carolina, we're going to still be seeing some of the sun shown. You need to be very, very careful. You can't stare at that just like you can't stare at the sun normally. And a regular pair of sunglasses is not enough.
Not enough. Okay.
Yeah, you need to have those special solar eclipse glasses.
Okay. And so can you make those? Can you buy those? How do you get something like that?
That's not to make them. These are things that need to be done with precision and care by reputable dealers. You can purchase those.